Yo, Corey with Real Filmmaking, and today I'm going to show you how to get started using your first DSLR. So, I gotta be real with you guys for a moment. When I first got my hands on a DSLR, it was not pretty. I had the camera and I was all like, what does this do? What is this? Oh, dang, what's going on? I was like a kid in a candy shop, lost and confused and wanting a lot of sweets. But I had a good friend of mine sit me down, give me kind of like a basic run through of the camera and like kind of get me set up to go out and start shooting. And so that's what I want to do for you guys today. Give you the basic settings that you need to set up your camera and help you get out and start shooting video. Because I know for me personally, that was the best way I started to learn my camera. To get out, to get it in my hands, and to actually get some footage. So, without further ado. So today I'm going to get you guys started using your first DSLR. I'm looking at a Canon 60D here, and though this is an older camera, it's very similar to a lot of entry-level DSLRs on the market. Some of the menus and buttons might be slightly different, but it should be similar across the board, even with Nikon cameras. One thing that I love about cameras like the 60D is the flip-out oscillating LCD screen. It's invaluable to be able to see yourself when you're doing stuff like YouTube videos, and being able to have that flexibility is a bonus. So let's blast through some of these menu settings for optimal filming. So first we've got movie exposure, you want to leave that on manual. Next we got autofocus, you've got a couple options, quick face live, live, and quick mode. I leave it on face detection live. We've got autofocus with shutter button, I enable that. Autofocus with metering button, default to zero. ISO speed setting, 1/3 of a stop. We got highlight tone priority, put that on disable. Movie record size, 1920 by 1080p for HD. You've got some other options, 1280 by 720, 60 frames for slow-mo. Sound recording, I leave this on manual if your camera has this option. Go over to silent shooting, leave that on disable. Metering timing, 16 seconds. And grid display for composition, I leave that on for my get good shots. Exposure composition, I leave that dead center at zero. Auto lighting optimizer, leave that at standard. Picture style, I set mine at neutral. White balance, daylight, auto white. We've got shade, cloudy, tungsten, white fluorescent, flash, custom, and color temp. I leave it on auto. Custom white balance, that's where, again, if you want to set your custom. Quality for pictures, I leave it on large for raw. I disable the beep, it's annoying. Release shutter without card, enable. Image review, if you want to look at your pictures, I leave mine off. And peripheral illumination, I keep that disabled. Some of this other stuff is just kind of like about the data. So it's not super important, so we can kind of skip through all this stuff. Next, you got your auto power off to save your batteries. I leave mine at a minute. Format the card before you shoot, so you're good to go. How you number your files. LCD brightness, how bright you want your display. You got date and time, language, video system. If you're in Europe, it's going to be PAL. Anywhere else, NTSC. And I think that about rounds up our... Oh, sensor cleaning. Yeah, auto clean. That about rounds up all of our information for our shooting settings. So with that, you guys can get out there, take your camera out, just go film some stuff. See what your camera feels like in your hands. Get used to messing around with different settings. And until next time, go film something.